Yeah, I might be punishing my AI a little too much.
Punishing, punishment, more punishment. Punishment, punished for the more punishment. Punished, punishing.
The ton of punishment.
I know punishing an AI agent is crucial for its training, but it always makes me feel like the bad if we're doing that. It's just like being a parent who has to scold his kid for misbehaving. Huh. If only I could... So I've made an AI dad who will have to punish the AI instead of me. Now that I can delegate this awful responsibility, I don't have to think about it anymore and can calmly sleep at night. And just in case AI Dad starts also feeling bad, I gave him a bottle. Unfortunately, the bottle is not see-through, so there is really no way to tell what are the contents, but it is definitely working. The idea of this simulation is simple. It is late at night and it's time to go to bed.
Why it's so bright outside?
You see, that's actually a very good question. Anyways, this little fella is refusing to go to bed and instead wants to play on his phone in Oblivion? Yeah, well, the AI dad, let's call him Bill, is too tired for this and all he wants is to watch TV in peace. So he decides to help little Pogo go to sleep. Little Pogo will have to learn how to avoid the big guy and complete the entire game without getting caught. He will get a small reward every time he plays the game, as well as a huge reward if the game is completed. Moreover, since getting yeeted across the entire room is not bad enough, he will also receive a punishment for getting caught. In order to navigate the room, our little friend will shoot several ray casts in a small radius all around him, which will tell him whether there is an obstacle nearby or something worse. The big guy, on the other hand, has a reduced field of view, shooting ray casts in a small arc in front of him. This dude will be rewarded for chilling next to the TV and of course smacking the hell out of little Pogo. Also, he will get a punishment every time he spends more than 30 seconds away from the TV, meaning he will have to stop his chase every now and then to come back and check whether he missed anything important from his favorite TV show. Quick note, during editing I actually noticed that I made a mistake and realized I never changed the is watching value after setting it to true. Which means, in theory, our dude was never punished for not watching the TV, no matter how far he was. Which might explain some behavior later on in the video. Back to the video. In the first round, both agents are quite lost, not knowing what the hell is going on, which is quite useful for little Pogo, because he has time to play the game and learn that this is his main goal. Meanwhile, our other dude is aimlessly wandering around and investigating the wall. Little Pogo seems to be slowly learning how to navigate the room as well, and soon he will complete the game from the first try. Oh, the second camera is getting naughty. At round 8, Bill understood how to make that music stop and for the first time helped little Pogo fall asleep. I hope both of them are having fun, well, AI Dad surely does, because next rounds they kept repeating the same game where little Pogo will try to run away, but not too far. On iteration 25, finally small guy managed to run away, leaving the AI Dad confused, staring at the wall. Slowly but surely, the game is getting completed, but oh, it seems Bill got unstuck and is now trying to follow, but he couldn't make it. Looks like Bill just gives up on the idea of chasing little Pogo. I'm wondering what the strategy here is. Oh, never mind. Getting stuck between bed and table allows little Pogo to safely complete the game and get the juicy reward. Next few rounds, however... About 60 training rounds in and our dudes are already running across the entire house. Bill is following the small dude and not giving him space to breathe, while little Pogo makes use of his agility and plays the game in small iterations, teasing the AI dad. When suddenly AI dad gets tired of this and goes to the kitchen, I guess for a bottle refill, and what happens next was pretty surprising. Bill seems to be stuck next to the bathroom, not even looking at little Pogo, when without any warnings he turns around and rushes towards him, stops to catch his breath for a second, dude ain't young after all, and then rushes again, catching little Pogo off guard and sending him to sleep. However, only two rounds later, little Pogo understood that he shall use his speed advantage and kept on running in circles, dodging the old guy. Oh, I forgot to mention, I'm actually training 30 parallel instances, so two rounds are technically around 60. After running in circles and gaming right in front of Bill, little Pogo actually managed to complete the game once again. Next several iterations, the same strategy was attempted, but AI Dad was not having it anymore, being able to trick his opponent by cutting corners at some turns, thus negating the speed disadvantage. Smart, smart! Round 67 starts well for little Pogo, being able to evade Bill's charge, after which he seems to have been left alone. You could already call easy peasy, but all of a sudden this small dum-dum decides to rush to the TV in what looks like an attempt to turn it off. This immediately triggers the AI Dad, who runs into little Pogo, explaining him how bad of an idea that was. After that, for about 100 rounds of back and forth, on day 180 something weird happened. It all started as usual, Lil Pogo dodging the initial charge, but then he got cornered and AI Dad was just looking? He was staring Lil Pogo down, and it must have been really intimidating, because despite the distance between them, Lil Pogo is not even trying to play the game on his phone. And as if that was not enough, AI Dad comes closer, fully obstructing the vision and movement of Lil Pogo, leaving no place for escape. Psycho. But guess what? Same thing happened again, yet this time next to the exit door. And again. This kept on going until on round 203, after getting chased down and blocked in the corner, after tremendous efforts trying to push away the ginormous squishy blob that is not letting him move, our little fella not only learned that he should not play while being so close to AI Dad, which allowed him to survive, stay awake for so long, but also somehow managed to escape his grips. He was too shocked to play games afterwards and just waited for the round to end behind the safety of the toilet. Next 100 rounds or so, the balance of power was constantly changing, so I'll let you enjoy a short time lapse. Around iteration 316, little Pogo figured out that he shall spend more time in the middle of the house, his strong point, since there are no obstacles, allowing him to easily evade Bill. Despite AI Dad's attempts to cut corners, seems like little Pogo can't be caught anymore. He now learned how to quickly change directions to avoid AI Dad's trickery. This was a crucial moment in his training, allowing little Pogo to complete game after game, filling him up with confidence. Heck, on round 318, he even decided to be the bully and started running around AI Dad and turning off the TV. Next round, after giving his best trying to chase this little prick and almost catching him, AI Dad said fuck it and just started watching the TV, fully ignoring little Pogo. I didn't think too much of it, writing it off as AI randomness. It is common in machine learning that from time to time, AI will do seemingly dumb actions in attempts to explore other possibilities. However, it happened again next round. And the one after that. And next one as well. Here, AI Dad saw he can't reach little Pogo because of the bed, said fuck it and went to watch TV. Little Pogo was left alone, and it seems he could not believe that either, because after a long pause, he started playing and was able to complete the entire game in one sit. I left the agents trained for about 100 more iterations, and finally, after around 12 hours of training, here is the final result. We will have a best of 3, which means that the first agents to get 2 wins, well, wins. Pause this video right now and let me know in the comments, who do you think is gonna win, AI Dad or Little Pogo? First round wasn't too dynamic and was quite short. Little Pogo swiftly avoided all danger in the beginning, but then AI Dad got one step ahead and caught our little fella in the corner, securing the first victory. Round 2, on the other hand, brought some surprises. Despite starting almost identical to the first one, with little Pogo valsing in the kitchen, soon after it became obvious that something bigger is going on. This time AI Dad either tried to block the corner once again and something got him confused, or he was simply lost, but he missed it. Seeing this, little Pogo immediately seized the chance, stepping slightly further away and starting playing, keeping a close eye on the AI Dad. While this poor fella was struggling with dementia, trying to understand what the hell is going on, little Pogo kept increasing the distance as well as slowly filling up the progress bar, reaching almost 40%. Bill's brain was broken, at this point he barely moved at all, with rare exceptions when he seemed to get himself stuck even more. He would twist between the bed and the table, his vision being obstructed by everything around him. Little Pogo understood that as well and started playing in much longer turns, attempting to speedrun the game. He almost reached 70% completion when suddenly AI Dad starts running. First towards the TV, slams into the wall, changes direction, rushes towards the kitchen, slams into the sink, and then, out of nowhere, rushes towards little Pogo, catches him off guard, and sends him to sleep, securing second victory. Well, there is that. AI Dad won and is now finally able to continue his favorite activity, watching the TV. Oh, you are curious what is this TV show that he's always watching? I'm glad you asked. This is my Patreon page. Huge thanks to the subscribers Kabernot, Spartan King and Red Nugget. You guys are the legends. If you want to be part of future videos and help support the channel, consider subscribing to the Patreon page, link in the description. Meanwhile, go watch this other video I made where I trained 10,000 AI Persian warriors to fight against 300 AI Spartans. In the next video, I am finally going to implement the cavalry. Bye!